Hello everyone. Let us start solving problems on trusses. I hope you are aware about what is a truss and what will be the assumptions made in truss. Okay, in first module while discussing the influence line diagram, I think sir has already discussed. So what is a truss? So a truss is a structure which is made up of slender members, okay, which can take the loads only at the joints and have the internal forces only the axial forces, either tension or compression. Correct. So if you see any particular truss, so in that particular trusses the loading will be applied only at the joints, okay, and joints are only the pin jointed, okay, pin joints, not rigid joints. If you see the beams and frames, they will be rigid jointed. So if you see the trusses, they will be pin jointed. What you mean by pin joint and what you mean by rigid joint? So usually, so suppose if you consider a particular frame subjected to a type of loading, so it will have the deflection, correct, something like this. So after deflection, this, if the angle between these two members before deflection and after deflection, if it remains same, then it is rigid joint. If the angle between these two members, once if it is subjected to loading after the deformation, if it is changes, then it is pin joint. Okay, so a pin joint is one. So after the deformation, the angle between the members, it will be different. So before, if it is 90 degree, after deflection, if it is 120 degree, then that is joint is pin joint. If it is before deformation 90 degree, after deformation it is 90 degree only, then it is rigid joint. So your beams and frames will be rigid jointed structures, but these trusses will be of the pin jointed structure. A truss is a structure made up of slender members, can have the only forces at the joints and can produce the internal forces as axial forces, and they are pin jointed. Correct. So to analyze this particular trusses, there are usually three methods. One is method of joints, method of sections, and graphical methods. So nowadays nobody is using graphical methods, so we can stick on to either method of sections or method of joints. Okay, so we'll be solving two problems on trusses. So I will be explaining the first problem here, the method of joints, and in one more problem I will be explaining what is method of sections. Okay, so here a truss is loaded as shown in the figure. The cross sectional areas are as indicated in figure. Find strain energy stored due to loading. Take Young's modulus is equal to 72 GPa, gigapascal. Okay, giga newton per meter square. Okay, so this is the truss. So it is a simple truss made up of three members, so we can say it is a perfect truss. Okay, so where the number of members in it are just sufficient in number such that it will not be undergoing any deformation usually. Okay, but still due to the application there will be there. But so here we need to find what will be the strain energy stored due to the loading. If this is the load, so what is the strain energy stored in this particular truss, okay, made up of three members. Okay, so if you observe this, so joint A, joint B, joint C. At joint B the loading is there, the concentrated load, the value is 200 kilonewton, and joint A is having the hinge support, so the reactions will be two. So this and this. Okay, so joint C, the roller support perpendicular to this, the loading. Okay, so either you consider vertical, or if you see the figure then it may be looking like horizontal, let it be. So this is the way in which the reaction will develop. So this is one reaction, here one reaction, here one reaction. Okay, these are the three reactions, and here the distance of this particular joint is given. Okay, so this is the line, so 0.75 meters, 0.75 meters. okay, so this from here to here distance is 1.8 meters. Okay, so you can draw this line, and depending upon this line, you can identify what is the angles. Okay, if this is 1.8 meters, if it is 0.75 meters, what is this angle, and similarly, what is this angle. Okay, I hope you are understanding. I draw a line, so find this angle, this angle. This is 0.75, this is 1.8. Okay, so first you need to find what will be the forces developed in each members, either by method of joints or method of sections. Before that, so here one more load is there, that is 120 kN at point joint B. So we know that strain energy for a single member under axial force is P square by 2AE into dx within the limit 0 to L. Correct. So this expression already we have derived by considering a bar element subjected to axial force. What will be the strain energy stored in a member? That is integration within the limit 0 to L P square by 2AE into dx. But usually the truss is made up of many such type of individual members. Not only one member, there might be three members, there might be four members, there might be six members. Correct. Hence the same formulae for truss can be used as with this. For the entire structure, if you want to find what is the strain energy stored, then U is equal to summation of P square L divided by 2AE. Okay, where P, L, A are respectively axial force, length, cross-sectional area respectively. So here they have mentioned the cross-sectional areas. For BC is 3000 mm square, AB is 1800 mm square, and AC is 1200 mm square. Correct. So first we need to find the reactions. So how we'll find the reactions? So this problem, the reactions, whatever we have discussed, this and this reaction. Okay, so you need to use three equilibrium conditions: sigma V equal to 0, sigma H is equal to 0, and sigma M equal to 0. Correct. So if you apply sigma V equal to 0 directly, vertical forces, this is horizontal, this is horizontal, this is vertical, so you will get this reaction. If I say this as R A V, okay, vertical reaction at A, which is vertical, if I say this one, that is obviously, so 200 kN downwards, so it has to be opposite to that, sigma V equal to 0. So R V V will be getting 200 kN. Correct. Similarly, if you want to find the these two reactions, if I apply sigma H is equal to 0, even this RH, then RC, that is RAH, okay, and this is RCH, both are unknowns. Correct. So for that reason, what we'll do, first apply sigma M A equal to 0. Okay, take moment about A equal to 0 due to all the forces. So RCH into this 0.75 plus 0.75, then 200 into 1.8, then 120 into 0.75, take moment about A equal to 0, then you will be getting what is RCH. Then apply sigma H is equal to 0, you will be getting what is RAH. Correct. So if you find this, so you will be getting the reactions as 200 kN minus 300 kN leftwards, so 120 kN. Okay, so minus 300 plus 180, nothing but total is 120. Okay, summation of V, this is 120. So you are getting it. Okay, so after finding the axial forces in individual members, so how to find the axial forces in individual members? So by method of joints or method of sections. Okay, so how, what is method of joints? Okay, here we'll be explaining method of joints. So what is method of joint? Okay, so you need to consider the FBD of a joint where there are only two unknown member forces are acting. Okay, where there are only two unknown member forces are acting, then apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0, and find what will be the unknown forces. But the condition is, to start with, assume the unknown forces as tensile or compressive, anything, and check the forces. If you are getting negative value, so then whatever the assumptions you have done, that force is opposite to that. Okay, suppose here if you see, so if I consider joint B, okay, if I consider joint B, so how many forces are unknown here? The force in the member BA is unknown, the force in the member BC is also unknown. Okay, so I will assume them acting away from the joint. So this is force in the member BA. Okay, this is force in the member BC. Correct. So acting away from the joint is nothing but tensile. Acting towards the joint is nothing but compressive. I hope you are aware about this. And also here the forces are acting. So this is 120 and this is 200. Okay. For this particular joint, if you apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0. Okay, two unknowns, two equations are sufficient. Okay, sigma V equal to 0. Okay, so let me write again, sigma V equal to 0. Okay, so if you apply sigma H is equal to 0, okay, first you need to find this angle theta. So as I said, draw a line and find this angle theta. So this is 1.8 and this is 0.75. So tan inverse, whatever the geometric equation you can use, and find this. Okay, if you apply sigma H is equal to 0, this is 120 rightwards plus, then resolve this, okay, with this angle FBC cos, FBA cos, okay, minus, ultimately both are leftwards minus. Then in terms of sigma H is equal to 0, you will be getting one equation. Then again similarly, sigma V equal to 0, resolve the forces on vertical direction, you will be getting again two unknown, one equation. So from this equation, solve the two equations like simultaneous equations, ultimately you will be getting what will be the forces in this AB member, what is the forces in BC member. So once you get these two forces, okay, if it is tensile, you need to show it acting away from the joint. Okay, if it is compression, you need to show it acting towards the joint. This is compression and this is tension. Correct. I hope you are aware about this. Okay, so once you find these forces, similarly then again consider next joint, either this or this, because only unknown force remaining is AC. Then again apply, draw the FBD of the joint and apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0. So you will be getting what is the force in the member AC. Okay, this particular method you need to go on applying for all the different types of joints. Okay, if you find like that, so ultimately you will be getting the force in the members. Okay, so member AB, member BC, member AC. So length of the members are given in mm. Okay, so they are given in mm or what? Yes, they are given in 1.8 meters. This is 0.75 plus 0.75. So it will be 1.5 meters. Okay, they are given in meters, but see this areas, cross sectional areas are given in mm. So convert these also in mm. So while substituting here, all should be in single unit, either mm or else meter. Okay, convert this or convert this. Areas are given mm, so convert this into mm. Okay, so find the lengths of this BC and AB. So this length is 1.8 meters. So you need to apply the Pythagoras theorem and you need to find what is BC, what is AB, the length. Okay, once you find the lengths, you will be getting these are the lengths. Then areas in mm square given, then Young's modulus given. Okay, then load. Okay, in by method of joints you have formed, then you know the equation, ultimately strain energy stored in the member will be equal to P square L divided by 2AE. P is there, L is there, area is there, and Young's modulus is there. Okay, substitute all the values for each individual members. So for member AB you are getting the strain energy, and member BC you are getting the strain energy by this formula. For AC member you are getting the strain energy by this formula. So once you find the strain energy stored in each individual member, Then add all the three members to get the strain energy stored in for the entire truss. Okay, so total strain energy, that is summation of P square L by 2AE. You will be getting as 1005.09 kilonewton mm. So force is in kilonewton and the displacement or length what we have found, so those will be mm. Okay, so strain energy stored in the entire truss is 1005.09 kilonewton mm. That is the strain energy stored in the all the members. Okay, so then one more problem. So the other is strain energy for all the truss member of the entire structure. Yes, so this is again one more type of problem, truss problem again, where it is subjected to 40 kiloton load. And how many members are there in this? AB, BC, BD, DC, AD and DE and AE. 1 2 3 4 5 6 7, total 7 members are there. Okay, so this is total 90 degrees. Okay, so it is a cantilever type of truss. So again you need to find this reactions, okay, by using equilibrium conditions, sigma V equal to 0, sigma H is equal to 0 and sigma M equal to 0. First find the reactions. Okay, then you need to find the lengths. So length of the members are required, so you need to find the lengths. So this is 6 meters. Okay, from here to here it is 6 meters, correct? So if it is, this is 6 meters and this is AE is 3 meters. So this is 90 degrees. Pythagoras theorem, apply this, you will be getting what is the length of this. Okay, so once you find this length, then similarly you can find BD length, AD length and ED length and DC length separately by considering each individual triangle separately, correct? So once you find all the lengths, okay, so then you need to find what will be the forces in the members. Okay, either you can use the method of joints or method of sections. Okay, so in previous problem we have discussed method of joints, so let us discuss what is method of sections here. Okay, so the theta angle, before that, so just theta is given by 26.56. okay, using your trigonometric relations, so sine, cos, whatever you can apply. Okay, so then by using equilibrium condition support reactions, you are getting this RA vertical, RA horizontal, then RE horizontal. Okay, this is horizontal, horizontal and vertical. Okay, so you will be getting these reactions. So once you get these reactions, you need to apply the method of section or method of joint. Suppose if you are applying the method of section, so what is method of section? So you need to pass a section through the members and you need to consider the entire left hand portion and right hand portion of the structure after cutting the section. The section may be vertical, horizontal, curved or inclined, and again the section should pass from the members cutting maximum of 3 members. Okay, maximum of 3 members. Okay, it can cut maximum of 3 members, and you can use the equilibrium conditions once you cut a section and consider entire left hand or right hand portion. So 3 equilibrium conditions, sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0 and sigma M equal to 0. All the 3 equilibrium conditions, 3 unknowns, 3 equilibrium conditions. Okay, by that you can find what are the forces in the members of the truss. Suppose, for example, okay, so if I pass a section like this, one section, okay, first, okay, either I can consider entire right hand side or entire left hand side. Okay, if I consider entire right hand side, so this force I will be assuming as tensile, this force I will be assuming as tensile, this is joint C where the load is acting, this is force in the member BC, so this is force in the member CD. Okay, this angle is known. Apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0 and also sigma M equal to 0. But however, here only 2 unknowns are there. So you can apply sigma H is equal to 0, sigma V equal to 0. 2 equations, 2 unknowns. You will be getting this. you will find these two forces. Suppose if you consider the same section, entire left hand side, so you need to draw this so as it is. Okay, this will not be facing any problem. Okay, this A, this is suppose AE member, this is AB member, this is AD member, and this is DE member. So here we have cut the section. This is force in the member BC. This is force in the member FCD. Okay, so then again, when you consider this entire thing, apply sigma h is equal to 0, sigma v equal to 0, sigma m equal to 0. Since it is cutting only two sections, two equations are sufficient. Okay, you will be getting what are the required forces. Okay, similarly, the section may be passing through something like this. If I cut a section like this, it is cutting AB, BD, and DC. Consider this entire right hand side or this entire left hand side. Then apply sigma h is equal to 0, sigma v equal to 0, sigma m equal to 0. Okay, fine. Go on finding the forces in the members. The section may be like this, cutting AB, AD, or DE. So ultimately, it should cut the sections passing through the maximum of three members. If the section is passing through four members, that is also will do, but one force should be known to us. Okay, the maximum of unknown forces when you pass a section should be three, not more than that. Okay, so how many possible sections are possible such that you can find all the forces you can pass the section? So the section may be vertical, horizontal, inclined, curved, whatever it might be. Okay, so by that you can find what is the forces in the members. If you are perfect with sections, you can go ahead with sections. If you are comfortable with the method of joints, so you can go ahead with method of joints to find the forces in the members of the truss. Okay, so these are the reactions. So here, after finding the axial forces in each individual members, either by method of joints or by method of sections, the following table can be created. So this formula, the energy stored in each individual member, length, area, Young's modulus, and force. Again, the length in mm, area in mm. So for all the members, okay, find the forces, the method of joints and method of sections. Once you find the forces in the members by method of joints or method of sections, this is the strain energy stored, and for the entire structure you will be getting 140.05 kilonewton mm square. That is the strain energy stored in the entire truss. Okay, this is how you are finding the strain energy stored in the members. Okay, that is truss. Okay, so here Young's modulus was given. Okay, areas are given, the lengths are given. In some problems, what they will do, they will not give the areas. So that time you can go ahead with A as constant. Okay, so Young's modulus, if it is not given, E as constant. So usually they will mention, if not mentioned, so you will be going ahead with the constant, A as constant, E as constant. Okay, this is how you will be solving the problems on trusses. I hope it is clear. This is with respect to strain energy methods. Okay, so this strain energy method, there are some limitations. It we have solved problems on beams, frames, and trusses. Okay, this strain energy method can be conveniently used for finding deflection in structures only under the following situations. Okay, the structure is subjected to a single concentrated load, or else if UDL is there, if UEL is there, then we cannot apply this strain energy method. Okay, deflection required is at the loaded point only and is in the direction of the load. The deflection what you are finding, that will be in the direction of load, and the structure is subjected to single concentrated load. Okay, so we can find the deflection under the point load only. Okay, this is the limitation, but with the concept of this strain energy, whatever we have discussed, in the subsequent methods we can overcome these limitations. Okay, so we'll be discussing the method of joints and method of unit load method, sorry, method of unit load method, and one more is method of Castiglione's theorems. So With that, we can overcome these limitations, Cassegrain's theorems and unit load method. So we can discuss those methods in future classes. Thank you.